Hello children, this is Rajesh Dwivedi and I am here with a new PowerPoint video on Indian agriculture. Agriculture is the practice, art and science of cultivating the fertile land for raising crops or for rearing livestock. It started about 12,000 years back and includes not only growing of crops but also forestry, pisciculture besides animal husbandry. So what we find that according to time, agriculture, the meaning of agriculture has changed. This term has been derived from a Latin word agri, that means field, and cultura, that means cultivation. Agriculture is actually the primary and economic activity which serves as a base for human activities from the time unknown. India, as far as India is concerned, it is an agricultural country and about 2/3 of its population is directly dependent on agriculture. Overall, agriculture, it accounts for nearly 14% of its GDP, 12% shares of the total value of the country's export, and provides employment to about 58% of the labor forces. Now, the main features of Indian agriculture is that still today, we have hardly 42% area under the irrigation. Large area has been brought under the high seeds, high yielding variety seeds. Because of that, the first green revolution and second green revolution in 1990s that started. This modern technique in agriculture and as well as the primitive method of using animals is the main significant of England, India's farm operations. Here we find the wide climatic varieties and the soil is very fertile in the different parts of the country. So because of all this quality, the crops are grown throughout the year. Now, it generates also the working capital for non-agriculture development, that means it actually supplies raw material for agro-based industries like textile, sugar, vanaspati, that means the refined oil, etc. And it provides a large part of the market for industrial goods like many things is manufactured in industries, that is especially for agriculture, like fertilizers, pesticides, implement, machineries and many more. The cropping pattern in agriculture are different, like unicropping, which is also called monoculture or sole cropping, where focus is given on raising one crop. On the other hand, in the dual cropping, two crops are raised. The focus is given that they require almost identical climatic condition. Then the intercropping, where focus is given on raising two subsidiary crops in a row along with the main crop. Then comes the strip cropping, means where crops are grown on the slope in such a way so that it may not cause soil erosion. And then mixed farming, where apart from agriculture, rearing of animal or livestock is also done. Now, to bring betterment in agriculture, many revolutions also started. These revolutions are the different sorts, like green revolution for overall food grain production, the white revolution for better quality and quantity of milk, then yellow revolution for better quality of oil seeds, then blue revolution that is for fisheries, and then silver revolution that is for eggs, then red revolution that is for tomato and meat, then you find the round revolution that is for potato. So what we find that there were many actually revolutions which is done in agriculture to bring a betterment. Now there are different types of overall agriculture practices done, like horticulture, means where focus is given on growing of fruits, flowers and vegetables, and then apiculture, raising and keeping of bees, then viticulture, cultivation of grapes, and then sericulture, where production of silk is focused, olericulture, that means the growing of vegetables that is spread on the land, and of course, as I said just now, means fish farming, that means by constructing a special tanks and ponds, the fishes are reared over there. Then in agriculture operations, there are the three steps. First is the input, means what required actually in agriculture. It requires capital, seeds, fertilizers, machinery and labors. Then comes the processing, where the weeding, removal of the waste, sowing, plowing, irrigation, harvesting, rearing and breeding of cattle, that is done. And what we get in the output? The crops, the wool, dairy products and poultry. Some schemes also started to bring betterment in agriculture, like National Horticulture Mission started in 2005 and 2006, National Agriculture Insurance Schemes implemented in 1999 and 2000, especially for the rabi crops. Then focus is given on Price Stabilization Fund Scheme of tea, coffee and tobacco growers, that was launched in April 2003. Then Micro Irrigation Scheme was launched in January 2006, especially for arid areas, where the focus is given to promote WUE, that means water use efficiency, the better use of water by adopting drip or sprinkler irrigation. In our country, the Commission for Agricultural Cost and Price recommends the minimum support price for crops. So what we see over here, that means this is a brief about Indian agriculture. Hope you like this video. Thank you very much.